Let's study the calculation of electric flux through a circular disk due to a point charge. See, we consider a circular disk which is of a small thickness and say it is of radius r. And on its axis at a distance L, we have placed a point charge plus Q. We know that a point charge originates its electric flux uniformly in all directions. And say here we are required to find the amount of flux from this charge Q which passes through the surface of this disk. So here we can see that if we consider a conical region of which the base coincide with the disk and the vertex with the location of point charge, then whichever electric flux or lines which will be originated from the charge within this region will pass through the disk. So in this situation, to calculate the electric flux through the disk, we consider a small elemental ring we consider, which is of radius x and width dx. And we calculate the flux through this element because electric field due to the charge at various points of the disk is non-uniform. So here at the location of this element, the electric field will be in radially outward direction and the magnitude of electric field can be written as kq by this distance square, which is root of L square plus x square. So here electric field will be kq by L square plus x square. And the surface area of this element will be in the direction normal to the disk, which is ds, which can be written as 2 pi x dx. And if the angle between these is theta, this will also be theta, and we can write down that electric flux through the elemental ring is, through this elemental ring flux is E dot ds, or which can be written as E ds cos theta. If we substitute the values, electric field is kq by L square plus x square, ds is 2 pi x dx, and the value of cos theta we can substitute from this triangle as L by root of L square plus x square. So in this situation, this plus d phi can be written as, here we can also write k as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, out of which this 2 pi gets cancelled out. So this will be q l by 2 epsilon naught multiplied by x dx by l square plus x square to power 3 by 2. And now we can find out total flux through disk is by integrating this d phi within limits from 0 to r. So here this ql by 2 epsilon naught is a constant. We integrate x dx by l square plus x square to power 3 by 2 from 0 to r, which is the standard integration, and this can be written as ql by 2 epsilon naught. On integrating this expression, we'll get it minus 1 by root of L square plus x square, limits from 0 to r. If we substitute the limits, or we can just reverse the limits due to the negative sign present here. And if we take this L n, the result will be q by 2 epsilon naught, and this will be 1 minus L by root of L square plus r square. This is quite a useful result. You can also keep it on tips. And in coming sections, we'll study that by using the concept of solid angle, this result can be obtained just in one step. That is by uniform distribution of flux in the surrounding of a charge in the overall solid angle. So we'll take it up in the coming section, another alternative way to calculate the same result.